Today we are going to discuss about the last module of your syllabus, that is the lighting control. So actually, what do you mean by lighting control? A lighting control system is an intelligent network-based lighting control solution that incorporates communication between various system inputs and outputs related to lighting control with the use of one or more central computing device. Lighting control systems are widely used on both indoor and outdoor lighting of commercial, industrial, and residential spaces. Lighting control systems serve to provide the right amount of light where and when is needed. So, actually, the main purpose of lighting control system is to serve or is to provide the right amount of light where and when it is needed. Lighting control systems are employed to maximize the energy savings from the lighting system, satisfy building codes, or comply with green buildings and energy conservation programs. Lighting control systems are often referred to under the term as smart lighting. Okay, it is called the smart lighting because it is comparable with the green buildings, energy conversion program. That's why it is called the smart lighting, and also it is used to provide the correct amount of light where and when it is needed. The term lighting control is typically used to indicate the stand-alone control of the lighting within a space. This may include occupancy sensors, time clocks, and photocells that are hardwired to control fixed groups of lights independently. Adjustment occurs manually at each device location. The efficiency of and market for residential lighting controls has been characterized by the Consortium for Energy Efficiency. The term lighting control system refers to an intelligent network system of devices related to lighting control. These devices may include relays, occupancy sensors, photocells, lighting, light control switches or touch screens, and signals from other building systems such as fire alarm or high voltage AC. Advantages of lighting control. So the major advantage of a lighting control system over standalone lighting controls or conventional manual switching is the ability to control individual lights or group of lights from a single user interface device. This ability to control multiple light sources from a user device allows complex lighting scenes to be created. A room may have multiple scenes preset, each one created for different activities in the room. Okay, a major benefit of lighting control systems is reduced the energy consumption. Longer lamp life is also gained when dimming and switching off lights when not in use. Wireless lighting control systems provide additional benefits, including reduced installation costs and increased flexibility over where switches and sensors may be placed. Now, what are the benefits of lighting control? Actually, a lighting control system is a network of devices like lamps, sensors, switches, and so on. that lets you set the lighting in a room to your exact needs. The system might be wired to your building's electrics or thanks to a new and ever-evolving technology, operated wirelessly over frequencies similar to your broadband connection. Now, actually, in specific way, we are discussing about the benefits of the lighting control. Means it can help us to be more energy efficient. They can be installed with little disruption. They allow you to tailor your lighting for more flexibility. They help rather than hinder productivity. They can be used with little training. Now, to be more energy efficient means with an automated lighting system, you can ensure you are getting the right type of light where, when and when you need it, rather than having lights blazing in unoccupied rooms all day, every day, and wasting money in the process. So did you know that lighting alone can account for up to half of your business total electricity bills, and that on average 30% of energy you use could be going to waste. So it said that the lighting control system in office and other commercial premises have the potential to reduce energy cost by 90%. A lighting control system generally uses three kinds of sensors or controllers, like motion sensors, time controls, and light sensors. So motion sensors, these detect when someone is entering or leaving the room and activate or deactivate the lighting accordingly. Time controls, this switch the lights on or off automatically according to the schedule set manually on the system, but can be overridden whenever necessary. That means, and often need to be meet the requirement of modern and flexible businesses. Then the light sensors. These measure the brightness of the daylight coming through the windows, then calculate how much artificial light to provide in support. The brighter the daylight, lower the amount of the artificial light. While there are simple steps you can take to reduce the amount of light you use, replacing fluorescents with LEDs, switching lights off at night, cleaning the windows, nothing conserves energy as effectively as a lighting control system. The next point is to be installed with little disruption. In the past, some businesses have avoided lighting control system because of the complex electrical work and also the associated costs involved. However, new wireless technology means deploying such a system has never been simpler. Wired lighting control system. Installing a wired lighting control system involves uniting all the electrical circuits in one central location, such as a switch or keypad. While this allows for a very reliable system, it does require more detailed planning and more complicated work and is more expensive as a result. And sometimes it means tearing down walls and ceiling to gain access to the building's electrical wiring, which can disrupt the business day-to-day operations. To overcome this problem, the wireless lighting control system comes in the market. So with wireless communication system such as CMD's Odyssey, however, there are none of these problems. The sensors and central hub like a broadband router can be fixed easily to a wall or ceiling, out of view if need be. The switches and keypads can be similarly mounted in whatever position is most suitable for people to access. All of these can be achieved in a fraction of time it takes to install an equivalent wired system. In this case study, we show you how wireless lighting can provide the ideal solution for retrofitting old industrial buildings without disturbing the original features. Now it increased the flexibility. Where a traditional light switch or bank of switches limits you to turning single lights off and on, a lighting control system allows you to activate individual lights or group of lights from one device, whether it's a switch, keypad, or remote. Set lights to automatically turn on, turn off from one device. Turn on, turn off, or dim at precise times, particularly when a room or building is likely to be unoccupied. Create customized lighting scenes to provide a specific type of lighting, such as in an office where workers needs to be able to read and use computer screens. Give employees the freedom to override the automated settings and tailor the lighting in their working environments to their own needs. The next point is help rather than hinder productivity. Many business and commercial premises suffer from unsuitable lighting, whether it's a matter of being too dim or too bright. In most offices, employees work both on paper and on computer screens. Typical lighting is adequate for paperwork, but it's considerably brighter than the ideal conditions for working on a PC or laptop. When the lighting isn't appropriate for the kind of work being carried out, the employees can feel discomfort and become unproductive. With a lighting control system, employees are able to adjust the lighting above their workstations or workplace to suit whatever tasks they need to be performed. They are also aided by the light sensor, which take constant measurements of the natural light entering through the window, tweak the artificial light accordingly, okay? Can be used with little training. It could be counterproductive to install a money-saving system that's so complex. It requires you to spend more of your finances on trainings. Lighting control systems are generally designed to be very user-friendly, with initiative switches and remote control and web-based application that most people will be familiar with through using similar applications on their smartphones or tablets, etc. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the types of lighting controls. The most common types of lighting controls include the basic lighting controls, dimmers, motion, occupancy and photosensors, timers, and network lighting control system. So, the basic lighting controls. The basic lighting controls consist of a manual on or off switch. As we use in our daily life, in home, okay, or in our college. In order to save money with these types of lighting control, the individuals in the buildings must remember to turn them on when they enter the room and turn them off when they leave. Using energy efficient light bulbs like LEDs, CFLs, with basic switches can help reduce the electricity bills. Number two is the dimmer controls. dimmer controls provide variable indoor lighting. When you dim light bulbs, it reduces their wattage and output, which helps save energy. Dimmers are inexpensive and provide energy saving when the lights are used at a reduced level. They also increase the service of life of the light bulbs significantly. However, dimming reduces an incandescent bulb's lumen output more than its wattage. This makes the bulbs less efficient as they are dimmed. Now, in case of dimmer control, we use the two parts. One is dimmers and CFLs, another is dimmers and LEDs. Unlike incandescents, the CFLs do not lose their efficiency with dimming. Some CFLs are compatible with standard dimmers, which will be indicated on the package. Others require special dimming ballasts and bulb holders. Fluorescent dimmers are dedicated fixtures and bulbs that provide even greater energy savings than a regular fluorescent bulb. Dimming a CFL that is not designed to work with a dimmer switch is not recommended, as this can shorten its life significantly. You can change the light bulbs and ballasts in fluorescent lighting fixture rather than replace them. Now, dimmers and LEDs. The light emitting diodes, light bulbs can be used with dimmers. LED bulbs and fixtures must be designed for dimming, and you may need to replace the existing dimmer switches with ones that are compatible with an LED lighting product. The packaging or accompanying instructions will indicate if the product is dimmable and which dimmer products are compatible. Fully compatible LED dimmers are expected to become more common as the LED industry expands. The third types of lighting control is motion sensor control. The motion sensors automatically turn outdoor lights on when they detect motion and turn them off a short while later. They are very useful for outdoor security and utility lighting, because utility lights and some security lights are needed only when it is dark and people are present. The best way to control might be a combination of a motion sensor and the photo sensor. Incandescent floodlights with a photo sensor and motion sensor may actually use less energy than pole-mounted high-intensity discharge, that means HID security lights, controlled by a photo sensor. Okay? Even though HID lights are more efficient than incandescents, they are turned on for a much longer period of time than incandescents using this dual controls. So HID means the high intensity discharge light tubes do not work well with just a motion sensor, as they can take up to 10 minutes to produce the light. The number four is occupancy sensor control, and this is very important for your examination purpose. Okay. So, for occupancy sensor detects the indoor activity within a certain area. They provide convenience by turning lights on automatically when someone enters a room, and save energy by turning lights off soon after the last occupant has left the room. Occupancy sensors must be located where they will detect occupants or occupant activity in all parts of the room. There are mainly two types of occupancy sensors. One is ultrasonic sensor, and another is the infrared sensors. Ultrasonic sensors detect sound, while infrared sensor detect heat and motion. In addition to controlling ambient lighting in a room, they are useful for task lighting applications such as over kitchen counters. In such applications, task lights are turned on by the motion of a person washing dishes, for instance, and automatically turn off a few minutes after the person leaves the area. Next, the photosensor controls. Photosensors are used to prevent outdoor lights from operating during daylight hours. This can help save energy because you don't have to remember to turn off your outdoor lights. So photosensor sense the ambient light conditions, making them useful for all types of outdoor lighting. And these light sensitive controls are less effective inside the home because lighting needs vary with occupant activity rather than ambient lighting levels. Many LED night lights, however, have this feature built in, which makes them effective and easy to use. Next is the timer control. A timer can be used to turn on or off outdoor and indoor both the lights at specific times. There are two types of timers. First one is a manual timer, which plug into an electrical outlet for controlling objects such as lamps or light strings, and involve programmable digital timers which look like a digital thermostats, which automate indoor or outdoor lighting. The programmable timers are not often used alone for outdoor lighting because the timer may have to be reset often with the seasonal variations in the length of night. However, they can be used effectively in combinations with other controls. For example, the best combination for aesthetic lighting may be a photosensor that turns light on in the evening and a timer that turns the light off in a certain hour of the night, say 11 p.m. For indoor lighting, timers are useful to give an unoccupied house of lived-in look. However, they are ineffective for an occupied home because they do not respond to changes in occupant behavior like occupancy sensors. Now, using timers with CFL and LED lighting. Timing controls work well with CFL and LED light bulbs as they do not interrupt the circuitry. This is especially true with manual timers that use pins for setting the on and off times. Now, the manual timers are the compatible with LED, CFL and incandescent lighting. Programmable digital timer, check the package label to be sure it is compatible with the type of lighting you want to use, okay? The last is the networked lighting control system. The most advanced type of lighting control system is a network system, which can be a part of building automation system, which is abbreviated as BAS, means building automation system package, or designed as a standalone system. Network lighting control system allow the operators to control the lights from their computer or handheld devices that contain the lighting system software. Okay. Operators can turn lights off, on and off, and set timers to control the lights. Advanced software programs can even store data and create the user's charts so that energy uses can be precisely monitored. Actually, this can also be done by CAD, okay, computer aided design. So today I will stop here.